All right, Jesse, you mentioned yearning. for you know, learning. I hope I said it right.
Yearning
for learning.
Yes, yearning for, it could pass.
Okay.
And it rhymes plus. But anyway, let's not water this down. It's now about time we cross over to Willis the Word Master. I'm sure he has interesting words for us this week, as always.
Let's see.
Well, dear viewers, it's that time when we get down to good English pronunciations and we go straight to our collections of the week. Our first word is right here, the definite article that is a bit tricky for many people to pronounce well. When it comes before a word that begins with a consonant sound, you say the, just like the door. But when it comes before a word that begins with a vowel sound, you say the apple. But when you use it for emphasis or to stress, when maybe you're introducing something or somebody who is famous or important, you say the. You stress it with the, fairly long E, the, like the Mike Tyson. So just to display for you what I'm talking about is right here. The door, the apple, and the Mike Tyson. That is the way to go if you are keen on using good language. Then we go to our next word, and the next word is a noun. You say regime or regime. Don't say regime. Regime is common but inaccurate. You say regime or regime, and I'm talking about a method or system of government. Then our next word is right here. You say mayhem, mayhem. Don't say mayhem. When we talk about confusion and fear that is usually caused by acts of violence, you say mayhem, not mayhem. Then our next one is a verb, and it's right here. When you talk about recovering, to recover after a period of illness or being sick, you say recuperate, recuperate. But you can also say recuperate, recuperate, or recuperate. So the two pronunciations are acceptable. Then we have a word that is fairly long, and for tonight, I want you to try it out. Can you try it out? I'm not saying you wear it, but can you try it? Just try pronouncing it, dear viewers. Well, you say acquaintance, acquaintance, and we are talking about a person or a thing that you've had some contact with in a slight way, an acquaintance. That is the way to pronounce this long word. Then let's get to a word that is common but tricky. So how do you say this one? Well, the D after N is not pronounced. It's silent. You simply say handsome, handsome. So don't say handsome, handsome, no. Handsome, just like you say sandwich or sandwich, but you don't say sandwich, 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 no. Sandwich, sandwich. That is the right pronunciation. Then let's get to a word that is not very common. It's formal, and you say obliged. This word is used normally to give some thanks or gratitude to somebody. You'd say most obliged or obliged. Obliged or obliged. So get it right, especially like when you are in court and you say most obliged, or you can say most obliged. Then let's get to the next word. Those who love literature would really love this word, but you say nostalgia, nostalgia. That feeling of sadness mixed with pleasure and affection when you remember the good times in the past. You say nostalgia. Don't say nostalgia, nostalgia, no. Nostalgia. That is the pronunciation. Then we have that painful, you know, a swelling on somebody's breast, or when you have it on an animal's udder, you say mastitis, mastitis. Don't say mastitis or mastitis, no, mastitis. And then finally, in our collections of the week, we have this common word that many people find themselves saying vulture, please just avoid that. Don't say vulture. The first U takes the mid central sound, just like in umbrella. So you say vulture, just like culture, not culture, and sculpture, not sculpture. Otherwise, let's go straight now to our collections of the week. A Kenyan who is in the Central Republic, that is in, you know, what we call Central African Republic. So please, Paul Mwaura Kamau, keep it up. It's KTN News and you're watching Mind Your Language. Keep it up. But you say code for C-O-D and code for C-O-D-E. Code, C-O-D, code, C-O-D-E. Then Victoria Kosgei of Rongai, you say orangutan, that ape, orangutan. You remind me about so many things, but you say orangutan. And then your second word is paraphernalia. Edwin Omiti Jabuya of Kandiege Karachuonyo in Homa Bay County, you say entrepreneur or entrepreneur, but you can also say entrepreneur or entrepreneur. What we should avoid, dear viewers, is entrepreneur. Very common. Entrepreneur? No, not in English. Anyway, we have Charles Guaro of JKIA Nairobi. You say cabin, not cabin. Just like cabin crew, the cabin crew. Then we have hostess, an air hostess. Don't say hostess, no, hostess. Then we have Edwin Kadieda, another Kenyan from Homa Bay who is currently in Djibouti. You say epitaph. Then Pius, if you like, Pius, that is locally. Pius C. Kiprono of Ngong, Kajiado County, you say harness or harness. Then we have Emily Emmy of Egerton University. Many people find themselves saying Egerton. You say Egerton, a very tricky name, Egerton University. Then you say you for the female sheep. Abdul Majid at Yemeni, you say doesn't. You are right, doesn't, not doesn't. Also, wasn't, not wasn't, wasn't. Now, we have Rick Okinda of Funyula Busia County. You say skepticism. But remember the one which has SC, that is the British spelling. But the one with SK, that is American spelling. But for both, you say skepticism. But then we have skeptics. Don't say septics, no, skeptics. Then Callistus Senior and Danger Charo of Kongowea, Mombasa. You say hyena. Many people innocently say hyena, no, hyena. Then we have Duncan Ombui and Alois Bill Maobe. You say amateur or amateur. Then amateurish or amateurish, but now with that amateurish, you have the stress on tarish, amateurish. But when it's amateurish, that's the way to say it. Then you have the word that is fairly tricky, synecdoche. Those who love literature may know what I'm talking about, synecdoche. And then we have grotesque. Then we have Mwalimu Vidija Dalizu of Eldoret, you say guys. Don't say guys. That is G-U-I-S-E. Guys. Under the guys. The guys. Not the guys. Now, we have Baraka Mohammed of Mandera and Job Awur, a.k.a. Nyakwarjamoko. Weh. Until I have now just to say weh, because when the names come from that side, you get what I mean? But names always make us proud of ourselves, just like we are very proud of our country, Kenya. So, Nyakwarjamoko, you say stature. And then you have hoodlum. Then we have dwarf. So this Baraka Mohammed and Job Awor, your three words: stature, hoodlum, and dwarf. Don't say dwarf. Then Teresa, if you like, Teresa Monyangi Bitange of Kibra, you simply say slum. And then we have Ed Onjala, you don't say Premier League, you say Premier League, a very tricky word. Then we have Eliaza Ongara. You just say pronunciation. You are right, not pronunciation. You are very right, Eliaza. And you say advise for the verb, that is with S, then advise the noun with C. To advise somebody a piece of advice. So we get them right as we go to our surprise word for tonight. And this word, it means to describe something, or maybe when you use a picture to describe or to show something, you say depict, to describe something, to depict. Don't say depict, which is very common. Depict. Then we go to our confusing words. And remember, as you watch KTN News or you watch Mind Your Language, you are sure to get also the spellings right. So here we have the right word, renowned. Renowned. That is famous and respected. Famous and respected. Don't say renowned. Renowned. And don't misspell it. This word does not exist. We don't have K. It's this one. Renowned. A renowned artist. Don't say renowned artist. Renowned, no. Please just avoid it and don't spell it this way. It's this one. So the right spelling is up here. You can see the tick. So let's get to the much asked about words. And I know for tonight, it's also part of the surprise. Please, you say grandfather, not grandfather. Grandfather, no. Grandfather, grandmother, grandson, and you also say granddaughter. So don't say grand. Grand for these words, no. Just like you say grandpa, grandma, grandparent, and grandchild. Don't say grand when you're using those words which always talk about relationships. So get them right, tricky but manageable, and nobody, not even Willis, that is myself, can be perfect or spotless in this world. Nobody. So let's get to that part of phonetic symbols, or what we call now the phonetic transcription. So just for you to know this symbol, this is the symbol or the phonetic symbol for the low front sound a. A, not I, not a. It's the sound a, the low front sound, the short one. That is, so you have it just like in the word apple, an apple. Please don't say apple or apple. Come on, but please avoid it. It's wrong. You say an apple. Then we have arrow, arrow. And then we have cat, cat. Not cat and not kite. It's simply cat with the low front sound a, which the symbol is right here. And you can also see the phonetic transcriptions which I've used right here. Finally, you also say man, man, not man. For the singular, it's, for the singular, you say what? The singular is man, not men, but plural, men. That is M-E-N. Otherwise, when you want also to catch more of the actual pronunciations, you just have to watch KTN every Friday night. That is Friday Briefing, and the segment is Mind Your Language. On behalf of my cameraman, that is Fred Moturi, I have now to take you back to Nairobi. But before that, I have just to remind you that you can also interact with me on Twitter at Willis Ochieng 1. That is at Willis Ochieng 1. And next week, you may be struggling with blessed and blessed, beloved and beloved. You'll get them right here on KTN. For now, it's back to Nairobi.
Thank you very much, Willis the Wordmaster. I think my favorite one today was pious.
My favorite one was Premier League.
Oprah. Well, from now on, we know what to say.
Exactly.
Always a learning curve.
So do you tell Willis have a blessed night or a blessed night?
I don't want to risk. Let's just wait for next week. I'm playing it safe. So yeah, Willis, sure. Next week, we're waiting for that proper pronunciation of those two words. Beloved, already, okay. Anyway, that's how we wrap things up here on the Friday briefing. Thank you very much for watching.
I'm Jesse Rogers.
I am Ashley Mazuri. Our sign language interpreter is Damien Evans. See you tomorrow. Have a good night.